Vascular EDS is a rare genetic condition that is secondary to alterations of type 3 collagen, and it is due to mutations within the COL3A1 gene. Although the mutation is present since childhood, the disease only expresses itself clinically in the early adulthood. Once the first arterial complication has occurred, similar events will repeat unpredictably throughout the entire adult life. This is a source of significant morbidity and may lead to premature death. Therefore, formal genetic diagnosis and dedicated patient management is of critical importance in vascular Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Let's look at the arterial complications by type. Spontaneous arterial rupture is a characteristic feature of vascular EDS. However, ruptures are not constant and they are far less frequent than dissections and aneurysm formation. Ruptures occur predominantly in arteries that are normal in size and shape, rather than in previously dissected or aneurysmal arteries. Another characteristic complication of vascular EDS is carotid sinus fistula, which occur almost exclusively in women. Finally, arteriovenous fistulas at other locations may occur, but are even more likely after open surgery or endovascular procedures. What are the locations of arterial accidents? Medium-sized arteries as branches of the abdominal aorta, carotid or vertebral arteries as well as iliac arteries are commonly affected. Involvement of the aorta is also common, predominantly of the abdominal aorta. Accidents involving the thoracic aorta are reported predominantly in patients that have had a fatal event. The limbs also may be involved, most commonly the femoral arteries, popliteal and subclavian. Even more distal arterial complications are also common. What is the treatment of arterial accidents? In case of acute dissections, medical management associates minimal invasiveness, optimization of blood pressure control, and regular monitoring of the diseased artery. Sometimes, antiplatelet or anticoagulant therapy may be prescribed for a limited period of time. In the case of arterial rupture, depending on the importance of bleeding, the primary goal of treatment is to save the patient's life by all available means. The treatment of choice of small to medium-sized arteries is terminal embolization, either by glue or coils, depending on the presence of collateral vessels and on the importance of downstream organs. When embolization is not possible, the placement of a covered stent may be an alternative treatment. Finally, vascular surgery may be indicated or necessary in some patients and is associated with acceptable outcomes, particularly when performed in an elective setting.